are raising reason in a motion to my mind. You provide the fire. Father, we thank you for today. Thank you because we have had a beautiful day. And we thank you, O God, because we know that as we go into the hall of praise and worship, your presence will be evident in our midst, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Bye.
yesterday, today and forevermore. What to say is what to do. You never change, you never fail. You're faithful till the end. Faithful God, I worship you. I worship you. You're so faithful to fail me. Yes, Lord, you say.
Ourselves before your throne and adore your majesty, for you are God Almighty. Thank you, Eternal Father. In Jesus' most high name we pray. Amen. We welcome you to today's prayer meeting, and we pray that as we seek the face of God, the Lord will hear us and attend to us. You want to pay your tithe and offering? Please pay through Stanbic IBTC Bank, New Covenant Church, Agodi Center is the account name, and the account number is 920-154-9762. You will never remain the same. In Jesus' name, amen.
Let's bless her offering before we continue. Dear Lord, we thank you because out of much that you have given to us, we have just brought a little. We ask, O Lord, that you accept this and accept ourselves in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray that this is a seed, and therefore, O Lord God, you will cause multiple harvests even to be and come into the hands of everyone that have given. And for those who don't have to give, we pray, O Lord, that you will give them so that the next opportunity they will be able to give back. Thank you, dear Lord God. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Once again, we welcome you to this evening prayer meeting. The time of prayer is a time of refreshing. It's a time of renewal of strength. It's also a time that we tell the Lord that He alone is our sufficiency, and He alone is whom we put our trust in. We thank God for all that have been happening. We appreciate the name of the Lord for how He has been keeping His people. We also thank Him for what He has also been doing for our nation. And therefore, we are going to start our prayers this evening by bringing prayers of thanksgiving unto the Lord. The first reason why I want us to do this is because as a nation, and even a continent, the continent of Africa, the World Health Organization and all many knowledgeable people, they have said a lot. In fact, that we are about 3 months, or is it 3 or 4, into the epidemic in Nigeria and all the rest. What they thought, their projection was that by now, maybe about 40 million people. 40 million all over Africa. They say why? Because they thought that Africans are generally poor and our lifestyle does not really make for good hygiene. But in spite of this, imagine, Africa itself has not recorded 1 million, not to talk of 40. Nigeria too, the most populous country in Africa. Yes, we have a few here and there. I call them a few, when you know the population of this great country. So our first prayer this evening is to the Lord, to say, Lord, thank you for frustrating the imaginations of the knowledgeable one. That's our first prayer. Let's thank God deeply. Let Him hear our voices in our homes, in our cells, wherever you are. Pray, let God know that you bring appreciation. Because if not for the Lord, what would we have said? If not for the Lord, then where would we have been able to stand? If America and many other great nations, the effect is even more than we can imagine. Yet, He's keeping us. So we thank God for keeping us. And I also want us to thank God for keeping our household. Yourself, maybe you are married, your spouses, your parents, your children. There is no how. We still buy bread, don't we? And bread goes through also a lot of hand here and there. We don't have any option. We still go to market. Yes, the Lord is keeping us. So I also want us to pray, really appreciating God. Really appreciating God. In case you don't know, let me just explain. I'll be giving us time to pray this. But let me just explain something to you. Do you know that the bike man, you don't know his status? Do you know that even your neighbor that will say, hey, whatever, I move close to you. Even if you have a mask, before you, do you understand? You don't know the status. Many, many other ways that one can contract this kind of disease. Yet, He has kept you. And He has kept your entire family. That's the second Thanksgiving. I'll give you us about 3 minutes when we are praying. Then for sustaining members through this period. 2 Corinthians 9:10 says, He gives seed to the sower, bread to the eater. The Lord, in various ways, He has been sustaining His people. We have not turned beggar. The Lord has been providing for us. So that would be number 10 reasons for our thanksgiving. Number 4 is even for the survivor. In spite of the fact that, yes, we have some number, but we are also having growing numbers of survivor. Really. For those who have been able to survive, let's appreciate God. You don't have to know them, but let's appreciate God because they are members of this great country. Then we also want to thank God that gradually governments, they are talking about easing out the lockdown. The fact that at least they are thinking towards that, we will appreciate God. So brethren, for this and many other reasons, we now go to the Lord. I want you to pray, and I'll also be praying here too, thanking God, prayers of thanksgiving for our nation, for keeping us and our family, for sustaining all our members through this period for the survival of COVID-19 and even for the fact that the government is gradually easing out lockdown. Faithful God, we have come to say thank you to you. We have come to say thank you, Lord, even as our government is thinking of easing out the lockdown. As we are thinking of, oh, let's get better gradually to our normal life. For this also, we say thank you, Lord. We appreciate you. We appreciate you, Lord. We can never thank you enough. We can't, oh Lord, because you have been awesome. Great God, in you we put our trust. Great God, in you we put, oh Lord, our hope. You are our refuge, you are our habitation. You have the present help in time of need. You have been there for us, you are here with us, Lord. Blessed be your name. Thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Thank you, dear Lord God, because all glory, all honor, all adoration can only be given to you. Not to any man. Not because Nigeria will know how to do it better. Not because our government can even do it better. Not because even individuals that we are able to keep ourselves, but because you are faithful. Faithful Lord, we say thank you to you. Thank you for Nigeria. Thank you for keeping us. Thank you because we know you are at work in this nation. Blessed be your name, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. The other thing, because we are in Oyo State, our first prayer will inch on something. Up to maybe a week ago or thereabouts, somewhere in Oyo State, we seem to be a little bit like a desica because we felt the figure were not really much, like they were just few figures. But then, it's as if suddenly, we started hearing a lot of news of new infection here and there, to the extent that new fear starts coming in. 67, 57, 77, a lot of in a company, and so on like that. And when we look at it as children of God, we'll see that fear does not have any place. The Bible says fear torments. And Romans 18:15 says, we have not been given the spirit of bondage again to fear. We have not been given the spirit of bondage, but we have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. And therefore this evening, that spirit of adoption that we have received, we are going to bring that spirit of adoption to be able to play. My father is in charge now. You can imagine if they say they are giving money, oh, so many people there enter, and you suddenly realize that, oh, my father is the one, in charge. Say, oh, no way. Please let me go in. My father is there. So that spirit of adoption is what we are going to bring to pay. And one of the things, the basic thing that the Bible says, it was said in Habakkuk 2:4, repeated by Paul in Romans 1:17, and in Galatians 3:11. Is that the just shall live by faith. In other words, no place for fear. In other words, if truly you have accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, if truly you know yourself as a child of God, if truly you have the spirit of adoption within you, then you must not fear. You cannot fear. Why? because your faith will put you through. So our first prayer this evening, well, apart from the thanksgiving, is, Lord, help my faith in you to increase on daily basis. Please let me tell you something before you go. Help my faith to increase. Help me to trust you totally, no matter the situation, what the situation around me is saying. I will let you know this scenario. Yes, many of us, maybe you can stay at home. But what about our health workers? What about people who have maybe pharmacies and all the rest? There's no how they will open. And there's no how they will attend. And you can't know. How can you know somebody? In a country where many people are symptomatic, they don't show symptoms. And yet you have to relate. But the Bible says 1,000 can fall at your right, 10,000 at your left. It will not come near you. That's what it says. It will not come near you. No matter where it's falling, it will not come near you. Therefore, we want to go to the Lord in this spirit of adoption. Lord, help my faith on daily basis. Help me to trust you totally, no matter the situation around me. Let's pray. I want to put my trust totally in you. No matter what the figure is saying, no matter what people, the spread is, Lord, I am your child. And I put my trust in you that you will see us through this period. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. In Psalm 91, verses 5 to 7, that has become one of our main scriptures even for this period, because we are children of God. 5 to 7 says, thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at the right hand, but it shall not come near thee. Only with our eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Verse 9. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. Because you have made. So this evening again, we want to reaffirm that God, you are our refuge and our habitation. And we also pray, let your angel keep me in all my ways. Except the Lord keeps the city, they labor in vain that watches over it. Except the Lord keeps an individual, no matter what you do, even though we'll still do hand washing, social distancing and everything, but God factor is always there. So I will enjoy, let us pray, reaffirming God as our refuge and our habitation, and asking that wherever you, every member of your family, wherever we go, that his angel will keep us from all evil. Let's pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Then now we are also asking one of the prayers that I've always prayed, and I'm sure many of us too will be praying it, is that the Lord will shorten even the days of this epidemic. If we go by what they are saying, they said it will be with them, not with us, for a long time. But who says a thing and come to pass if the Lord has not commanded it? Nobody. In other words, if by their own permutation, it will be for a long time. But when the Lord raises a standard, then there's no one. Even his ordinary finger, Egypt and Pharaoh, they felt it. So if our God raises a standard, it doesn't take him. In fact, that same period, everything can be gone. So we will be asking God, the Lord, raise your standard against the ravaging epidemic. Shutting even the days of this epidemic. We want to go back to normal life. We want to go back to fellowshipping together. We want to go back to our children going to school. We want to go back to our different kind of occupations and what we do. So many people are affected. Many, many, many cannot do. Those event planner, what can they plan? Music, no way. A lot of places, people die. So we are going to cry unto the Lord by the spirit of adoption which we have and say, Lord, raise your standard against the ravaging epidemic. In Jesus' name we are praying. In Psalm 138, verse 7, it says, though I walk in the midst of trouble, thou will revive me. Thou shalt stretch forth thy hand against the wrath of my enemies, and thy right hand shall save me. I want us to pray it. Though I walk, though members of my family walk in the midst of trouble, yet you will revive us. You will stretch forth your hand against the wrath, even of the enemy, and your right hand will save me. And the right hand will save us. Let's pray it for every member of our congregation, every member of our family. You can open to it. Psalm 138, verse 7. 138, verse 7. Open to it and pray it. Pray it with intent. Pray it with faith in the Lord. Pray it with a trust that you have in your Father. And say, Lord, even when I walk in the midst of trouble that I don't know, even when I have contact with people with COVID-19 that I don't even know, Lord, help me, revive me. Stretch forth your hand to keep me. Stretch forth your hand against the wrath of the enemy. Let your right hand save me. Psalm 138, verse 7. Let's pray. Lord, though I walk in the mist, oh, though they are beside me, though anyone, O Lord, yet I put my trust. Stretch forth your hand. Stretch forth your hand. Lord Jesus Christ, let your right hand save me. In Jesus' name we have prayed. I hope you are following us. Please do. The next prayer we'll be praying has to do with even government is also already thinking of post-COVID, how to get back. The same way as individuals too, because we are also thinking of what to do after COVID. COVID-19 has been able to expose something, possibly that, your salary cannot take you far. At another time, some are not even sure if their establishment will downsize or whatever. A lot of thinking, what do I do? What is it? And so on. Still in that Psalm 138 that I said, verse 8 is what we are going to use to pray. And verse 8 says, the Lord will perfect that which concerns me. The Lord will perfect that which concerns me. Thy mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Thy mercies, O Lord, endure forever. So we are praying now that the Lord will perfect. Perfecting it with his direction. Telling us this is the way. This is how you go about it. The Lord will perfect all, not some, all that concerns me. The Lord will perfect it. Whether it's in post-COVID-19 or at any time, because it's my refuge, because I am his child with the spirit of adoption. And of course, I can cry and say, Abba, Father. And therefore, this evening, we are saying, Father, Lord, perfect all that concerns me. Can also use this opportunity to ask God for direction. Lord, what will you have me do? What do you want me to do? Open my eyes to my own pot of oil, from which, Lord, you will bless me. Open my understanding, O Lord God. Let's ask. Give me divine ideas that will move me on. Give me divine ideas that will move me forward. In Jesus' name we are praying. Amen. Now we are praying for the church. Not just New Covenant Church, but the body of Christ. The church, generally. We cannot say that we have not been affected by this COVID-19. It's not possible. So we want to intercede for the church. And our intercession for the church is that, Lord, everywhere your people are, strengthen them. Strengthen them. Lord, let there be reassurances on a daily basis. We don't see. Pastors don't even see them. But they are there, their Father. Lord, strengthen your people. Strengthen your people. Help our leaders. Even as they think of, how do we, if there is an, if they remove the restriction on churches, what do we do, how to go about it? Lord, strengthen your people. Give our leaders your direction. Give our leaders, truly your word, your direction at this particular time. Let's pray. Pray. Pray for the church generally. Pray. Lord, give us a voice that will be heard everywhere, even by the government. That when it says why, they all know it. Lord, let your word not be scarce, even among us. At this time, we need you to talk. At this time, we want to hear you. We want to hear your direction. We want you to guide us, Lord. In Jesus' name we are praying. Let's pray for the health workers. Let's pray for the health workers. They are in the front line of giving care. Many of them are getting infected, even abroad and even at home. And we have a lot of them that are even our members. So at this time, I want us to pray for all the health workers and ask that the Lord will bear them up in his hands. That the Lord will keep watch over them and their family. Let's pray for them. If you know any, you can mention their name. But let's pray for all these people. They are caregivers. But many of them, unfortunately, are getting infected. Let's ask for mercy. Let's ask that the Lord will bear them up. Let's ask that he will envelop them, even with his glory, as they go to work on a daily basis. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. So, now it's time to also pray. We prayed for our nation, but we want us to pray that even all this kidnapping, the banditry that is still going on in northern Nigeria, in spite of what is happening, the insecurity everywhere, during the course of the week, we were hearing of armed robbery in Akpete, in so many areas. Let's stand the ground against all these people and say, in the name of the Lord Jesus, we bring them to judgment. People who are inflicting more harms, even on the on already downtrodden people. People who are inflicting more harms in spite of what COVID-19 is doing. Let's bring them to judgment. Let's ask that the Lord will judge everyone that does not want us to have peace. Everyone that wants to be afflicting and exploiting the people of the Lord unnecessarily. Let's ask and bring them to judgment in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Now, as we go on, we also have a group of people among us, those who are supposed to write examination. WAEC, NECO, special examination. And we know any time from now, they say they will be asking them to start. Let's pray for them. They are our children, they are members of our church, our teenagers. Many of them are in that crucial period. Let's ask that the Lord will help them and that the Lord will keep them safe as they return back to school, for example. The Lord will help them. The Lord will keep them safe as they return back to school, even for their exams. In Jesus' name we have prayer. Let's begin to bring our prayers to an end while we intercede in the Spirit in the next minutes. We know not how to pray, but the Spirit pray within us. So let's intercede in the Spirit for the next 3 minutes.
He will never fail. I will lean on him. I will trust in him. He has promised he will never fail. His faithfulness is forevermore. His faithfulness is forevermore. He has promised. Oh, I will lean on him. I will trust in him. He has promised. Will never fail. His faithfulness is forevermore.
Thank you, Lord, for the time of prayer. Thank you because you are a faithful God. Thank you, Lord, because you hear the cries even of your children. Thank you, Lord, because we know you are at work. Thank you, O Lord, because we will always have reasons to glorify your name. Thank you because this Egyptian that we see today in COVID-19, we will see it no more in the name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father, Lord, because you will ordain peace over Nigeria, over all your state, and in our individual families in the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father and our Lord. None of us will be lost. None of us, oh Lord, we will all return back. Even, oh Lord, to Zion to give you praises. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Jehovah, Lord God, for we have prayed in Jesus' name. Thank you for being.
Raise it in the motion.